ओके, गुड आफ्टरनून टू ऑल ऑफ यू। माय साउंड इज ऑडिबल ना? हेलो।
यस
ओके,
सर।
नाउ लास्ट लेक्चर्स वी हैव गॉन थ्रू द जॉब इवैल्यूएशन एंड मेरिट रेटिंग। सो दिस इज एक्चुअली ब्रीफ डिफरेंस बिटवीन जॉब इवैल्यूएशन एंड मेरिट रेटिंग। ओनली यू हैव टू प्रिपेयर दिस थिंग, व्हाट इज डिफरेंस बिटवीन जॉब इवैल्यूएशन एंड मेरिट रेटिंग। सो first point is there in job evaluations. A job evaluation means determine the relative worth of jobs in our organizations, and it is the critical study of various jobs in order to assess their relative importance. So example, yesterday I have given different types of patterns are there, different types of forging dies are there. Okay, so different types of the crankshaft parts are there. So we have to decide the worth of that job. That is nothing but our job evaluation. Worth, this word is very important. Relative worth of the jobs we have to decide. That is called job evaluation. And corresponding or related point in the merit rating. Merit rating is the evaluation of the personality and performance of each employee by his seniors. It is a critical study of qualities, knowledge, ability of an employee. It is a type of performance evaluation. Means merit rating, this is related to the employees. Job evaluation, this is related to job. So job worth, we have to decide, that is the job evaluation. And employees' performance, we have to decide, that is the merit rating. Performance, merit rating. Worth of job, that is the job evaluation. This is our first point. After that, second point, it is mainly useful for creating fair and satisfactory wage system or structure. It act as a base for compensation system. Means, what is the use of this job evaluation? Very simple thing is there. We have to decide the wage system. We have to create the structure. Means, how much rupees will going to give to create that job. That is the system actually we have to decide. This comes under the job evaluation. Here, related point in a merit rating, it is mainly useful for promotion of the employees to get the higher post. It act as a base of promotion and transfer the employees. Means our merit rating, this part is related to the employees. So what is the importance of this? If anybody want to get higher post in industry, then we have to check his performance, his knowledge, his qualities, and that we going to just under the merit rating. So this is the second point under the merit rating. Now third point under the job evaluation is useful for explain the relative wage rates and for removing doubt among the employees as regards wage promotions. What is the next use of the job evaluation? So different jobs, different wages system is there. So there must be creating the problems among the workers. So we have to prove that this job must be this wages system. For that job, this must be this wages system. So we have to decide the different rates for different types of jobs. Pattern is there, different jobs is there. Then metal pattern is the different rates will be there. Okay, so rates calculations parts, it comes under the job evaluation. Similar point under the merit rating. Merit rating act as a guide to the employees for better performance. Suppose merit rating is not there, how we going to judge the performance? So depends upon performance, his salary, his wages, his incentive, motivation, etc. will be there. So merit rating act as guides to the employees for better performance. If merit rating is not there, there is a problems to get the performance among the workers and self-development in the futures. Then fourth point under the job evaluation, it is concerns with the evaluation of jobs, not concerns with the employees. Once again, same repeated point is there. Our job evaluations, this is related to job, not for employees. Now, merit rating, it is concerned with only rating or evaluation of the employees, not for job. Means this merit rating, it is related to the employees, and job evaluation, this is related to only jobs. The some repetitive point is there. Fifth point, it is useful for creating satisfied labor force. So whatever the work in industries there, through this we have to decide how much the labor force is required to create that job. So this idea you will get from the job evaluation. A similar point under the merit rating, it is useful for manpower development for rising efficiency of labor force. So how the labor's efficiency will increase by getting the incentives, getting the promotions, getting the motivations. So these things, if we collect and we apply on the shop floors, definitely the manpowers will get developed. Sometimes we need to give the training also. So this point is very important, because the depends upon the efficiency of the labors, the production and productivity will get increased. Now, sixth point, job evaluation is prior to merit rating, as it is rates the jobs themselves. So here, before merit rating, there should be job evaluation. So merit rating is the next to job evaluation, which is the first. This job evaluation is the first. First, we have to decide the worth of jobs, and then we'll go for merit rating. The sixth point, it indicates like this way. Seventh, it determines the wage structures aspectively, both to the employers and employees. In industry, 2 persons are there. Employees means those are working in that industry, that is the employees. Employers means management, or the industrial person. So there, if there is a constant job worth calculation is there, then there is no confusions between the employers and employees, and it is aspectable to both managements as well as workers. Next, it provides scientific base for determining the fair wage for each individual workers. This is the one of the scientific base to determine the wage for each individual workers. So suppose if you want to give 500 rupees for workers, so depends upon what? Depends upon merit rating, we have to decide this according to his ability and performance, and his increments, his motivations, his bonus systems. This is actually depends upon his performance, his ability, his personality, his knowledge, qualities. So everything about workers, it contained in merit rating. Everything about the jobs, it contains in our job evaluations. Correct. So this is the difference between job evaluation and merit rating. So this is the last point of our work measurements. Only you have to remember what is the job evaluation and what is the merit rating. Almost 4 to 5 marks questions will be there. Explain in brief about difference between job evaluation and merit. The 7 points you have to remember. This point, it is very important. So in industry also, what is the job evaluation that you have to decide? Because whenever new product is there, then we actually require the job evaluation. Once job evaluation is over, then we have to go for merit rating, because ultimately money is the parts in the output of the industry. So we have to decide the accurate job evaluation and accurate merit rating, so that there should not be problems in the output of that industry. So this is the major points in the job evaluation and merit rating. Apart from this, we have seen which methods comes under the job evaluation, which methods comes under the merit rating. That also we have seen. But only that methods you have to write, the remaining parts or explanation. If they will ask, then in last PPT I have given this. So four methods are there, job evaluation, merit rating. This point also you can add as the 8 point in the job evaluation and merit rating. So with this, our work measurement chapter is over. So one more point is there related to our chapter number 2. Like this difference also number of times asked in our exam, that is time study and motion study. What is difference between time study and motion study? Time study is technique of work measurement and it is technique of method study. So time study is related to work measurement. Work measurement means how much time is required for doing that particular job. This is, it comes under the time study. And method study, to study about present methods, method of doing jobs, forging, in which way we are doing the forging. First cutting, then heating, then putting on the dies, after that trimming is there, after that annealing process is there, after that heat treatment. This is the methods. So this motion study, this is related to methods, and the time study, this is related to the time required to complete the jobs. Now next point is there's under the time study. Time study is quantitative analysis. Quantitative analysis means number 1, 2, 3, how much quantity, like this. Quantitative analysis leading to establish of standard time in respective of the ultimate use of the result. So whatever result may be there, but how much the quantity is to be produced between the given period. For example, 8-hour shift is there in industry. In 8-hour shift, how much quantity will going to produce? So that analysis, it will comes under the time study. Motion study is quantitative analysis of work situation which leads to improvement of operation. Means whatever operation it is going in industry and what actually expected to make the improvement over the present methods, so that cost will get reduced, quality will get improved, more production and productivity. So here's a qualitative analysis also there, but here we have to consider the cost also. Along with the cost, there should be the qualitative analysis. Two major words are here in time study: quantity to be produced within the given the time, that is called the standard time. But here quality, in motion study, we have to analyze the quality of the jobs and improvement in the present methods. Then third point, time study is used to measure the operation time. The unit is being 0.01 minutes with the help of stopwatch. Since nowadays digital system is there, but previously they used to make of this stopwatch to measure the time. So here motion study used to measure the time of motion elements, means each element's times we can measure, so that downtimes we can reduce, means unproductive times we can reduce. The time being recorded to 0.0005 minutes by means of micrometers. So here's we have to decide the times for each elements and reduce the downtimes. But here's we have to decide the times to perform the work. So this is the difference between time study and motion study. Then last point is that by conducting time study, standard time is fixed for determining the wages. Means once we decide the standard times, we can decide the wage system. Wage system means per day, how much salary. Salaries, that is different. But per day, how much rupees will going to pay. So wages, this is per day, and salary, that is monthly. So per day is how much rupees will going to pay. This is depends upon the standard time. And maintain the efficiency in productions, means a good output should be there. Fourth point related to motion study: by conducting motion study, the best method of performing operation is established. So main purpose of this motion study, whatever existing method is there, that we have to change in such way that whatever downtime is there, so unnecessary cost creating part is there, that we have to remove and establish the new methods or new operation. So this is about the motion study. means in short motion study, it is related to the methods, qualities, then the total times required to do the particular activity for that particular motions. For example, we are reaching, grasping, moving. So for this time is there. So that time it is very important, and in that any unnecessary downtime is there, that we have to reduce. It is related to the motion of the bodies. Then the main purpose of this motion study is to reduce the cost, improve the quality and improvement in the existing methods or existing operation, and develop that new methods as per the requirement. But only one thing here you have to remember: downtimes you have to reduce, cost you have to reduce, increase the quality, production and productivity. This thing is there, and here we have to decide in the time studies the standard times required to complete the jobs. And here this quantity is very important. Accordingly, we can produce within 8 hours, how much quantity will going to produce, or how much time actually need to calculate to complete the job. So this comes under the time study. So this is actually 4 to 5 hours questions will be there. Difference between the time study and motion study. So after this, with this, our totally 3 chapters we have completed. First is introduction of industrial engineering. Second is method study. Third is work measurements. So based upon 3 chapters, I have prepared 2 tests. That is the test number 1, objective types or multiple choice questions. Second test, it is also be there. And after that, important questions related to these sections. And after that, next lecture, we're going to see our operation research parts. So test number 1, class test number 1, this is multiple choice question. See that question number 1 is there. Concept of mass production is given by which scientist? Here 4 or 5 scientists are there. So mass production concept given by who? That you have to search as per the materials provided to you. I have given multiple choice question. Notes also I have given. Additional materials I have given. PPT also be there. And recorded lecture links is also be there. So here you have to study and solve this all objective type of question, because this is very important from the examination point of view, gate point of view. So step by step you have to solve this and submit this PD format in terms of that PD format. Just scan it, make in the PD and send to me. So I will going to check this thing. So here first question, concept of mass production given by. So 4 scientists are there. You can select one of these. Then father of work study, who is this? There's F.W. Taylor is there. F.B. Gilbert is this. Out of these 2, you have to select. Founder of motion study, who has developed this motion study? So if you go through the industrial engineering, 2 scientists are very more important, that is F.B. Gilbert and F.W. Taylor. So you can just see that F.W. Taylor's which points have covered, F. Gilbert which point has covered. Then this type of question easily you will going to solve. Then father of time study, who has given against 2 scientist names are there. Concept of the work sampling. So this 4 or 5 points, this is related to who has developed concept of the work sampling, concept of the motion study, the father of work study, mass production. So you can search, because this type of questions always it has been asked in your gate exam. So that's why you have to remember through the given materials, whatever materials I have given, you have to study this and give the answer of this. Then the 6th question is, there are 2 techniques of work study, method study एंड वर्क मेजरमेंट टाइम स्टडी और मोशन स्टडी माइक्रो मोशंस और मेथड स्टडी सो दिस इज लिटिल बिट कंफ्यूजिंग पार्ट इज देयर सो यू हैव टू गो थ्रू दिस टू टेक्निक्स ऑफ वर्क स्टडी आइदर दैट इज मेथड स्टडी एंड वर्क मेजरमेंट टाइम स्टडी और मोशन स्टडी माइक्रो मोशन और मेथड स्टडी सो यू कैन गो थ्रू दिस So we have only introduction of industrial engineering. After that, method study is there and work measurement. So just you can go through and justify what is the expected answer for this. Seventh question is there. Process chart of circles with in square symbol denote. Means in industry, one process chart is there. In process chart, we are using different types of symbol. Circle is there, square is there, triangle is there, arrow is there. So here's what is the question? Circle is there and within that circle, square is there. It is related to what? Inspections with operation, inspection, delay, etc. So you can go through that five symbols and try to solve this question. Now question number eight is there. Personal allowance is taken generally. 4%, 5% for male, 7% for female, 4% male, 5% female, like this. So you have to remember the actual value of the personal allowance for man and woman. The fatigue allowance is taken as. So there are five types of allowance. So what is the actual percentage of allowance required while doing the process charts? So that you have to study. Then 10th. Motion study is mainly used where jobs are when we can use the motion study. So this is the question. When production is repetitive, batch production, non-repetitive, when we can use motion study. Mass production we can use, batch production we can use, or non-repetitive things are there, then we can just go through this. CMO chart stand for, means what is the meaning of the CMO chart, simultaneously motion cycle chart, simultaneously method chart, simultaneously micro motion chart. Out of this, you can select. So this is the CMO chart's meaning. BMT stand for basic motion times, basic method times, basic micro motion times. So you can select this. What is that BMT? Then next, MTA stand for motion time analysis, method time analysis, micro motion time analysis. Out of this, most of the words are you will feel that similar, but you can go through the at actually meaning of this. The most common competence levels activity in sampling. So this is actually 95. This part, it is actually statistical parts, even though questions always be there. So 95, this is the correct answer. Then 15. PMTS. So day before yesterday, we have gone through this predetermined motion times analysis or systems, or the different meaning should not be there. So you can select only one thing, that is the predetermined motion time standards or system we'll call. Critical examination of existing method and proposed method of doing work. That is called method study, work study, motion study. Out of this, motion study related to motion of our bodies. Okay, method study, this is related to only method. One method is there, this study will be there. Study of individual operator body movements. Now here you will think about the motion study. Measurement of small time 0.0005 means by micro motion, time study and method study. Always this time is very less, 0.0005, this is minute, very small times, always be micro motion. Thurblings, different types of thurblings are there, and who has developed the thurbling, that you have to remember how many types of thurblings are there. This is also 21st questions. Elementary motions commonly found in manual operation is called which thurblings, operation symbols or delay symbol, that you have to. Number of thurbling exists in motions, That is 18, 17 out of this, which is the correct answer. That you have to go. Then questions number 22 is the make correct sequence. Analytically approach to method study, record, select, develop, exam, install, and maintenance. So make the correct sequence of this method study. So first we'll select, after that record, exam, develop, install, and maintenance. This is the correct sequence. So you can also go through this, the sequence of method study. First, always we have to select the jobs. Then we can use the recording techniques. After that, exams, critical examination. After that, develop that method. After that, you have to install that, maintain, and maintain that method. Then 23, match the following. So right hand side, the symbols are there. Left hand sides, the operations or the particular activity names are there. Operation, so which symbol we can use? Inspection, which symbol you can use? Storage, which symbol we can use? Delay is there, which symbol is there? Transport, which symbol? Operations with a delay, that symbols you can select. So you can match the following. Now question number 24, bird eye view related to which chart? Either it is a outline process chart, flow process charts, or any other charts, that you have to decide. This is, I think, first points in our method study. Then in operation process charts, the different symbols are used. So what it indicates, the circle, what it indicates. Once again, this point is related to match the following. Flow process charts, it contains how many symbols? So 5 symbols, 2 symbols, or 7 symbols. Actually, here, if you go through the above 23 questions numbers, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 symbols are there. You can select that. But if you put the square inside the circles, then it will become 5 symbols. So you can go through this. Flow process charts used for distance and time, motion and times, path and times. So when we can use this flow chart, it is related to distance and times, motion and times, or path. Okay, so distance it is important, or path that is important, that you have to decide in the flow process chart. Now next, this is our class test number 2, correct? So the question numbers are continuously I have written. After 27, this is the question number 20. String diagrams used for path of the worker, path of the material, path of the equipment, for which we will going to use this string diagrams. Model is related to change in layout, change in material, change in equipment. Where we can use the model? Template and models definition. And the concept already given. Normally templates are made from cardboard, plastic, or steel, correct? So steel we cannot make, plastic, so normally you can make use of this cardboard. Combined operation chart is used for man material movement, man or material combination. So one man can handle two machines, or one man handles one machine. So like this combination is there. So where we can use the chart, that you have to select the correct answer. The path of light so photographed is called cyclograph, stenograph, semocycle charts. So photograph is required to decide the path. Means light has been used to decide the path of the movement. So what is the name of that? Cyclograph, stenograph, or semocycle chart, that you have to decide. At workplace, all required things should be at right place as per the sequence, as per PPC. So workplace, which things actually required? While doing the assembly, everything will be at right place so that we can go for the assembly. Main object of work measurements. What is the main object of work measure? To decide the standard times, effective use of all resources, to to decide the rating factors. So out of this, which is the correct thing? Normal times. Well, how to calculate normal times? This formula is required. Observed times is the rating plus our allowances. Standard times. So normal times or basic times plus allowances. That is the standard times. Then the question number 36. Tool breakage while machining the job. Types of allowance we can provide. Which suppose while machining tool will get break. Which type of allowance will be there? Power will get off, machine maintenance will be there, coolant will get off, breakage will be there, which allowance will be there? So if there should not be process allowance, personal allowance, it is not related, then you can think which allowance is required. Types of allowance related to management. So this is only one allowance which is not considered while calculating standard times, that is our policy, that management policy, always we used to say that. So easily we can make use of this. Type of allowance used when man can handle more than one machines. More than one machine. So suppose man is going to one machine and once that machine will get operated, then he will have to go to next machine. So the time will get lapsed. So which this allowance is that you have to think. Relaxation allowance contain personal allowance, fatigue allowance, process allowance. So out of these three, which allowance is related to the relaxations? More personal allowance is given to either, this is very important. More personal allowance is given to woman, man, or both man or woman, like this. Which allowance is more in industry? Motion picture camera is used in method study, micro study, or time study. So whenever cameras things there, small things we can justify. So you can decide the correct answer for this. Next, most accurate method in time study. Most accurate stopwatch methods, PMTS, or this synthetic data methods. Out of this, which is the most accurate method in time study? Time study is used for short cycle, repetitive job, non-repetitive job, or batch type of jobs. When we can use the time study? This is the question. Work sampling is used. When we can use for work sampling? Long cycle job is there. Job is in all teamwork. Short cycle job is there. When we can use the work sampling? MTM stand for methods time measurement, motion time measurement, micro motion time measurement. So already we have covered this point in PMTS. So what is the meaning of MTM? That you have to think over this. MTM, this point we have covered in our PMTS points. Then TMU stand for time measurement units. 1 TM, this is equal to 0.0 minutes. Methods time measurements unit, where we can use this TMU. Out of this, question number 48, this is related to gate. 1 TMU, that means how much minute. So ergonomics aims to improve. So ergonomics, this is not part of your syllabus, but what will affect on the improvement in the existing methods? So here's workplace, that is very important in the ergonomics, but this point is not related to your syllabus, even though you can remember this. After this 50, then 51, match the following. So the production layout, fixed layout, cellular layout, this is actually not related to your syllabus. For example, sugar industry is there. Which type layout is there? Line layout or continuous layout is there? Ship building is there. Fixed layout is there. Vehicle assembly is the product layout will be there. So in industry, this type of layouts always be there. Product or line layout, process or functional layout, fixed or static layout, cellular or group technology layout. So out of this more variety and small production, always be group technology layout. Ship building or aeroplane manufacturing is just fixed layout there. Process layout, it is related to our vehicle assembly, just like Bajaj Auto or Telco, they are using this type of product or line layout. In sugar industry, say that dumping of the sugars and it will go continuously up. At last you will get the sugar. This is the line layout, but this part is not in your syllabus. But even though you will going to study in the production and operation management, this part, so this part is also very important from the gate point of view. Now next 52 point is, question is there, job evaluation related to, see that, worth of job, cost of job, price of jobs. Price is different, cost is different, worth of job is there. Okay, so how to calculate the worth of jobs? Worth means nothing but value. Is it correct? So how to calculate function upon cost? Okay, so worth, that is called value. This is equal to function upon cost, means without affecting the function, we have to reduce the cost and decide the worth of the job. Then job evaluation decides the wage structure, bonus, incentive. So job evaluation main purpose to decide the per days amount, how much you will going to pay, and related structure, that is very important. Just now we have seen merit rating measures. It is related to the employer's performance of the worker, wages of the worker, skill of the workers. So just now we have gone through this merit rating. This is related to performance, quality, ability, capacity, etc. Then from chapter number 1, 2, 3, most important questions expected to be asked in your exam. So these questions I have written here. So first questions that is related to our first chapter. What is the meaning of industrial engineering? List object of industrial engineering. What contribution made by F.W. Taylor and F.V. Gilbert? What is the industrial engineering? Then object of industrial engineering you have to give. And what is actual work done by these two scientists, F.W. Taylor and F.V. Gilbert? That you have to explain in brief in the development of the industry. So this is the 7 mark questions will be there. Meaning, just in first chapters we have gone through this. Meaning means just a definition of industrial engineering. What is the objective of industrial engineering? Why we are going to study this industrial engineering? And what is actually contributions made by the F.W. Taylor and F.W. Gilbert? So these parts you have to write. Then question number 2, explain in brief about difference between production and productivity. List point to increase the productivity. So production means related to quantity to be produced in the specified times, means within the 8 hours, how much quantity will going to produce, that is production. And productivity means output divided by input. And which factors affect on the productions, that you have to go through the notes or the recording lectures or the link, and you have to give in brief which factors will affect to increase the productivity. What do you mean by work study? State the objective of work study and mention the two techniques of work studying, basic procedure of work study. So about the work study, we have gone in that method study parts. The two techniques of work studies, that is method study and work measurements. So whatever things related to method study and whatever things related to work measurement, you can combine and give the answer of the same. Next, you can give the meaning of the work study also. What do you mean by work study? Study of the present work and develop the new methods. It contains the the optimum utilization of the all resource, reduce the downtimes, increase the productivity, reduce the cost and quality, quantity, like this way. Then question number fourth is there, define method study. What are the objective of method study? List the types of charts used in method study and its purpose. So what is method study? Study of the present methods, from which point of view that you have to mention. What are the objective? Why we are going to study about method study? That objective, five points are there. List the type of the charts used in this. So already we have gone through this outline process chart, flow process chart, multiple activity chart, left and right hand charts. That chart you have to mention here. And which chart, when we can use. Process chart, when we can use. Flow process chart, when we can use. Multiple activity chart, when we can use. That you have to mention here. Question number fifth is there, explain in brief about the following charts with one example. See that number of charts in the, it is given in the question number fifth. Operation process chart, flow process chart and 200 process charts. So explain in brief about following charts with one example. Operation process chart. You can take any examples for manufacturing of the gear blind. Which symbols we can use here? Operations and inspection symbol. Only you have to note down that of activity. Operation, turning operation is there, facing operation is there, drilling operation is there. So how many operations and how many times we will go for inspection, that we have to combine, that is the process. Flow process chart, how the material will get flow from store to the last part. After that 200 process chart, I have given the example of carburetor assembly. We can do the carburetor assembly on the tables with help of two hands. So how we can optimum use of the both hand motions, it comes under the 200 process charts, that you have to explain. Then question number six is there, write short notes on string diagrams, travel chart, template and models. So string diagrams related to path, right? So while tracing the path and accordingly timing should be there. So whenever the flow diagrams problem is there, then we can use string diagrams. So on the shop floors, you can use the string diagram for path detection purpose. So to reduce the cross path, reduce the related timing, you can give the similar types of the examples. For examples, if we are cutting any materials, after cutting, we are going to put in the this four-jaw, three-jaw check of the machine, we need to travel from the cutting sections to the machine locations. And there we can go for the operation. And after finishing, we will have to go for submitting this. So this, if you use the string diagram there, is there any unnecessary path is there? These things you will get through the string diagrams, and unnecessary path we have to neglect. This shows in this string diagram. Then travel charts. So travel charts, it is actually difference. It is not only related to path, but how much quantity, how much weight that is travels from one place to the next place. So I have given one numerical problem also, 100, 200, 300. Operations are there. How we can make optimum utilizations by tracing this travel charts. Then C part is the template and models. What is difference between template and models? Models, that is the similar part to be produced before manufacturing. For example, pattern before casting, and templates actually be required in the production itself, whether we have manufactured that model, it is in correct position or not. I have given one examples of the end carrier slat used in sugar industry. To manufacture this slat, we required a template, and according to template we can manufacture that, and after manufacturing we can go for continuous production. The next seventh part is the distinguish between time study and motion study. Just at the end of our this third chapter, I have given the difference between time study and motion. Four points are there that you have to mention. Then next point is that what is thurblings? Thurblings, that is actually micro motions. Thurblings means micro motion. So what is actually thurbling? List any five thurblings and how it has been used in while making CMO chart, explains with one example. So thurbling, it is actually motions. So 200 process chart, it is actually a part of this thurbling. These micro motions we can catch up with camera, or nut bolt assembly, while doing the assembly we can use this thurbling. So you can make any assembly, and for any motion which symbol will be there, color coding should be there. It is actually 17 of thurblings are there, and out of this we can prepare only five and give the meaning, codification and symbol, etc. Then explain in brief about three important aspects of man machine system. So importance aspect of the man machine system. So this part, it is related to production and operation. This part, it is not covered in our syllabus. Okay. Next question is there, design display, design of control, working condition of environment. This question number 9, it comes under the ergonomics. So this part, it is not in your syllabus, but you have to remember the part of industrial engineering. Ergonomics is actually very important parts, working condition, different types of control, designs which is used in the industry. This part is actually in industrial engineering. You know this thing, that's why I have taken this part. But it is not part of our syllabus, question number 9. Write short notes on this anthropometry. This is also part of ergonomics. Workplace design, this is also part of industrial engineering. Minimum wages act, causes and prevention of accident. So question numbers 9 and 10, as per the syllabus, it is actually not in our part of the university syllabus. So ninth question number 9th and 10th, this is related to ergonomics. You can neglect this, but up to 8 you can prepare this. So instead of this, instead of 9 and 10, you can take a job evaluation and merit rating difference. Okay, so this is about our section numbers. Once we have completed all questions I have given here, the class test number 1, class test number 2, and important questions. Important questions I also given, and the difference. So this is about the today's lectures. So next time we're going to see the next part, I mean second section of this IEOR, that is operations research. So what is actually use of operations research, history of the operation research, and after that how we can use this operation research in the industry. After that, how we are going to solve the critical problems in the industry. So second section, that is all numerical questions will be there. So it is expected from my side to attend all the remaining lecture, because numerical problems are there. In our first sections, only one numerical problems is there, that is how to calculate the standard time. But in next sections, the simplex method is there, graphical method is there, critical path method is there, and transportation method is there. So all these methods, actually numerical problems will going to ask in your university question paper. So next sections, next time we're going to see. Okay, so today we'll stop these lectures. Okay, thank you.